Yes.
How's company people require translation?
Corey must kind of feel it.
Well, somebody's making it too. Okay. Do you simultaneous or work for life?
Yeah, work for life.
Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Krishnaya Bhutaya Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swami Niti Namaste Namaste Sarasvati Deve Kodarami Pachari Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschati Veshatari Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Adaita Gadadhara Shivasari Bhoya Bhaktavinoda Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare. Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare. So we've been speaking about Srimad Bhagavatam. And Srila Prabhupada, His Divine Grace, the founder of the Hare Krishna movement in the Western world, gave us the topmost religious scripture in existence. Srimad Bhagavatam, Bhagavatam refers to Krishna.
Bhagavatam is referring to Krishna.
And Srimad means beautiful.
Srimad znači prekrasan.
Or extraordinary beautiful.
Ili izuzetno lijep, divan.
Or we might also give another definition of Srimad, that which is decorated with all good qualities.
Ona možemo dati drugu definiciju Srimad Bhagavatam, ono što je ukrašeno svim divnim oblikama.
Bhagavatam, maybe some of you are not familiar with Srimad Bhagavatam, but it's the culmination of all transcendental knowledge.
Neko od vas možda nije upućen u Srimad Bhagavatam, ali to je zbir sveg transcendentalnog znanja.
And this is confirmed by the Lord Himself.
I to potvrđuje sam Bhagavatam.
When He left the planet, the question was, now that Krishna is gone, Krishna was here for 125 years, now how will religious principles continue after his departure?
Postavljamo se pitanje, kad Krishna napušti ovaj svijet, a bio je mimo 125 godina zadnji put, kako će se nastaviti duhovni principi, ko će promicati duhovni principi na koje?
When the Lord personally places His transcendental feet on the lotus on the whole world becomes purified.
Kada Gospodin postavi svoja lotusova stopala u ovaj svijet, čitav svijet je postao pročišćen.
The demons reduce.
Broj demona se smanjio.
Religious principles increase.
Religijska načela su se povećala.
And saintly people rejoice.
I sveti ljudi su se radovali.
The presence of the Lord brings about all these. The presence of the Lord brings about all these three aspects.
Principi Gospodina donose do svih ovih, pridonose svim ovim aspektima.
Now Krishna is gone.
I sad Krishna nema.
So how will the auspiciousness that He created continue?
Sada Krishna nema, i kako će se nastaviti povoljnost koju je On stvorio?
And it says, by the presence of Srimad Bhagavatam.
I rečeno je kroz Srimad Bhagavatam.
Srimad Bhagavatam is the manifestation of Krishna Himself.
Srimad Bhagavatam je manifestacija samoga Krishna.
Krishna comes in sound as His holy name, the Hare Krishna Mahamantra.
Krishna dolazi ovdje kao u obliku svog svetog imena.
But sound vibration, or transcendental sound vibration, comes in two aspects.
Transcendentalna zvučna vibracija dolazi u dva različita aspekta.
It comes in the transcendental chanting of His holy name.
pozivu obliku pjevanja njegovih svetih imena.
And it comes in literary form about the teachings and the descriptions of the glories of Krishna.
I dolazi u obliku literarne forme o učenjima i opisima slava gospodina Krišne.
Srimad Bhagavatam contains 18,000 verses.
Srimad Bhagavatam se sastoji od 18,000 stihova.
And each and every verse is full of transcendental meaning.
I svaki od tih stihova je pun duhovnog transcendentalnog značenja.
Srila Prabhupada was on a morning walk in Germany in 1975. With one professor named Professor Durkheim. Professor Durkheim. And Professor Durkheim, he liked
Prabhupada.
He was somewhat scholarly.
I on je imao akademski um.
A very respectable gentleman in front of Srila Prabhupada.
On je bio veoma poštovan gospodin koji je bio u društvu Srila Prabhupada.
Although he had much knowledge, he inquired from Prabhupada as if he was Prabhupada's student.
Iako on imao puno znanja, on je ispitivao Srila Prabhupada kao da je njegov učenik.
Prabhupada responded to Durkheim in so many, what we say, enthusiastic ways.
I što Prabhupada je odgovarao o tom čovjeku veoma, tom profesor veoma entuzijastično.
And Prabhupada was describing how we can understand God.
I što Prabhupada je objašnjavao kako mi možemo razumjeti Boga.
Well, what is the way to approach the knowledge of God?
Koji je najbolji način da priđemo znanju o Bogu?
Srimad Bhagavatam.
Srimad Bhagavatam.
And Prabhupada said there's 18,000 verses. And it takes 1 month to learn each verse.
I Srila Prabhupada je rekao da od ovih 18,000 stihova trebali bi naučiti barem nešto, neke od njih.
Because it's very transcendentally mysterious, Bhagavata. It's not so easy, simply by reading one can understand.
Srimad Bhagavatam je transcendentalno misteriozan i nije ga lako shvatiti ako ga čitamo sami.
So Prabhupada turned to one of his disciples and said, 18,000 verses, 1 month for each verse, how many years is that?
I što Prabhupada je jednom rekao svom jednom učeniku, ako bi jedan mjesec čitali jedan stih Srimad Bhagavatam, znači 18,000 puta po jedan mjesec, koliko je to godina?
And one devotee said, well, Prabhupada, that is 1,500 years.
Jedan učenik je rekao, to je 1500 godina.
And Prabhupada said, you have enough to read.
Sorry?
You have enough to read.
Što Prabhupada rekao, imate puno toga za čitati.
So we're confronted with an empire of transcendental knowledge in the form of Srimad Bhagavatam.
Znači, mi smo sada suočeni s jednim uzvišenim velikim znanjem u obliku Srimad Bhagavatam.
And Bhagavatam, although it's about Krishna and pure devotional service,
iako je Srimad Bhagavatam o Krišni i predanom služenju,
it deals with other subject matters.
Također govori o različitim drugim temama.
Question is, why?
Postavlja se pitanje zašto.
It's not so easy to understand Krishna.
Nije tako lako shvatiti Krišnu.
Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, I know everything, past, present and future.
Krishna kaže u Bhagavad Gita, ja poznam sve, prošlost, sadašnjost i budućnost.
I know all living beings.
Znam sva živa bića.
But me, nobody knows.
Ali mene nitko ne poznaje.
He doesn't say one person knows, he says nobody knows.
On ne kaže poznajem jedna osoba.
Maybe one person, her name is Radharani.
Zapravo jedna osoba,
she knows Krishna. So it's not so easy to know Krishna. In fact, it is practically impossible. Krishna is so great that as he continues, as time goes on, he becomes greater.
Krishna je tako veliki, tako da kako vrijeme protiče, on postaje još veći i veći.
We can't understand how great Krishna is, because as soon as we try, we look like a fool.
Mi ne možemo shvatiti Krišninu veličinu, jer sve što više pokušavamo, vidimo koliko smo budalosti.
People say God is great.
Ljudi kažu Bog je velik.
And Srimad Bhagavatam gives a little indication of the greatness of God.
I Srimad Bhagavatam ukazuje malo na to koliko je velik Bog.
Although it's called the empire of all religious scriptures, it's called the supreme pramana. It is called Paramahansa Samhita. It's called that scripture which is the most pure of all scriptures. Still, it's incomplete in describing Krishna.
Iako se Srimad Bhagavatam zove Paramahamsa Samhita, najuzvišenije od svih svetih spisa, iako je toliko čisti, opisuje Krišnine zabave, čak i taj Srimad Bhagavatam ne može u potpunosti opisati sve njegove zabave.
But it has enough information or enough transcendental knowledge where we can know Krishna completely.
Ali ipak ima dovoljno transcendentalnog duhovnog znanja pomoću kojega možemo sad upoznati Krišnu u potpunosti.
What does it mean to know Krishna completely?
Što to znači upoznati Krišnu u potpunosti?
Does it mean collecting a lot of knowledge?
Da to znači prikupiti puno znanja?
Or having great amounts of intelligence?
Ili imati veliku inteligenciju?
What does it mean to know Krishna completely?
Što to znači znati Krišnu u potpunosti?
It's a simple answer.
Jednostavan odgovor.
That means our love is complete. We have found the perfection of life through loving Krishna. That's what it means to know Krishna completely.
Voljeti Krishnu potpunosti znači razviti ljubav prema njemu. I to treba biti cilj našeg života.
Krishna is the sinusor, or the source, or the focus. The word sinusor means more like focus of all loving relationships.
Krishna je fokus svih ljubavnih razmjena i izbora.
And that loving relationship can be understood through Srimad Bhagavatam.
A te ljubavne razmjene se mogu shvatiti kroz Srimad Bhagavatam.
And part of that loving relationship is just to know how much Krishna protects his devotees.
Jedan dio tih razmjena, tih ljubavnih razmjena govori o tome koliko Krishna štiti svoje bhakte.
In the seventh canto is the story of Prahlad Maharaj.
U sedmom pjevanju Srimad Bhagavatama postoji priča o Šrimi Prahlad Maharaj.
Who was Prahlad Maharaj?
Ko je Prahlad Maharaj?
He was a 5-year-old boy.
On je bio dječak od 5 godina.
But he was a pure devotee of the Lord.
On je bio čisti bhakta gospodina.
He heard transcendental knowledge from Narada Muni, the great saint, while he was still present within his mother's womb. When he came out, he was fully self-realized.
On je čuo transcendentalno znanje od naroda Munija još dok je bio nerođen, zapravo dok je bio maternice svoje majke i kada se rodio bio potpuno spoznan kao osoba.
And Prahlad Maharaj had a father.
Prahlad Maharaj imao oca.
His name was Hiranyakashipu.
Njegovo ime je bilo Hiranyakashipu.
He was demon number one.
Bio je demon broj jedan.
He was the best of all demons. He had conquered all the universes. Had subjugated all the planets and all the demigods. Except for Brahma, Vishnu, Shiva, and Narada. That means he had captured all the universal arrangements.
Znači, on je preuzeo sve važne uređenja u univerzumu.
But he had one problem.
On imao je jedan problem.
He had many problems.
Zapravo imao je jedan problem.
Well, one problem he had, his son was a Hare Krishna.
Njegov sin bio Hare Krishna.
Sometimes that's a problem for parents.
My
child's a Hare Krishna, what will happen?
Sometimes
parents are like Hiranyakashipu sometimes. So he was trying to make his son a demon like him.
On je pokušavao svog sina učiniti demonom kao što je bio on sam.
Prahlad was fixed on Krishna.
Ali Prahlad je bio usredotočen na Krishna.
His father tried to encourage him to become a demon.
Njegov otac ga je pokušao ohrabriti da se demon.
Offered the kingdom.
Ponudio mu kraljevstvo.
Once he said, "You will become my successor."
Rekao mu, ti ćeš biti moj nasljednik.
You are my son.
Ti si moj sin.
Didn't work.
Nije funkcionirao.
Put him under the care of demoniac teachers and told him to preach demon philosophy and make him like me?
Vjerio ga je demonskim učiteljima koji su ga poučavali demonskoj filozofiji da postane kao on sam.
Well, I preached to his teachers.
Međutim, pravladi propovjedao čak svojim učiteljima.
And all to his
schoolmates.
He turned the whole school around.
I čitavoj školi
propovjedao. It was Asura Kula. He made it Guru Kula.
To je bila Asura Kula.
Yeah, all the kids became devotees and they were all sons of demons.
Iako su bili sinovi demona, djeca koja su, dječaci koji su išli u školu sa Prahladom, postali su bhakte.
That didn't work to change Prahlad. That didn't work to change Prahlad.
Ali nije funkcioniralo da promijene samog Prahlada.
His father was becoming so angry.
I njegov otac je postao tako gnjevan.
So he decided kill him.
I odlučio da ga ubije.
Now, what father will kill their son?
E sad, koji otac bi ubio svog
sina? Think about that.
Razmislite o tome.
It's horrible.
To je užasno.
But demons, as Prabhupada said, a demon will do anything.
Ali Šrila Prabhupada je rekao, demoni će učiniti bilo što.
They will do anything.
Oni će učiniti bilo što.
To fulfill their desires.
Da bi ispunili svoju želju.
So he put him under the care of his, what we say, assistants, and they tried to kill Prahlad in so many ways.
I oni povjerili svog sina svojim asistentima koji su pokušavali da ubiju Prahlada na razne nove načine.
Threw him in boiling oil.
Ubacili su ga u kuhano ulje.
The oil didn't work.
To nije funkcioniralo.
Threw him under stampeding elephants. The elephants went around him.
Ubacili su ga pod noge slonovima, ali ga nisu mogli zgaziti.
Tried to stab him with swords and spears. They had no effect.
Boli su ga na mačevima i kopljima, ali nije ništa bilo njemu.
Threw him off a cliff.
Bacili su ga sa litice u ambis.
Krishna was there to catch him.
Pa je Krishna bio dođe da ga uhvati.
He took a mountain and threw him in the ocean and threw a mountain on top of him. A mountain? You know what a mountain
okay,
is?
Okay, planina, da.
Yeah. He threw Prahlad in the ocean. And then threw a mountain on top of the ocean.
Bacili su Prahlada u ocean i na njega planinu.
Prahlad remained alive.
Ali Prahlad je ostao živ.
He called his Brahmins.
Pozvao svoje Brahmine.
He said curse him with spells and kill him with curses.
I Hiranyakashipu je rekao svojim Brahmanama, prokunite Prahlada i ubite ga svojim kletvama.
They tried everything.
Pokušali su sve.
The curses didn't work.
Međutim, prokletstva nisu funkcionirali.
The curses went back and started killing the Brahmins, because if you give a curse and it doesn't work, you get the results of the curse.
I onda to počelo ubijati te njegove
Brahmine. Be careful who you curse.
Ako Brahmana pošalje prokletstvo kletvu, a ona ne ubije tu osobu na koju su poslali, kletva se vraća.
The Brahmins were dying from their own curses.
Brahmane umirali od svojih vlastitih.
They said to Prahlad, save us. Prahlad saved the Brahmins. Not only was he not vengeful, but he was compassionate. So he couldn't kill him. And then Narani Kashipu decided to try and kill him himself.
Znači njega se nije moglo ubiti. I onda Hiranyakashipu odlučio da ga osobno sam ubije.
He took out his sword.
Uzeo svoj mač.
He understood his son was powerful.
On je shvatio da je nešto moćno.
He resisted all these ways of being killed.
On je shvatio da je nešto moćno Prahladu jer...
There were more ways, I just mentioned a few.
Na njega nisu utjecali nikakvi različiti načini.
So he was going to kill him himself.
I onda on učio da gubi sam.
The Lord appeared as the Srigadev.
I onda se gospodin pojavio kao
Sri Bhagavan i Srigadev, okay!
Jai!
And demon was killed.
I demon je bio ubijen.
I'll read a verse.
Sad ću pročitati stih.
This is Prahlad, after the killing of his father.
Sad ćemo pročitati što je rekao Prahlad nakon što njegov otac bio ubijen.
7, 9, 19. My My Lord, my dear Lord Nisringadeva, O Supreme, because of bodily conceptions of life, in body snows, neglected and not cared for you by you, cannot do anything for their betterment. I'll read it again. We'll do it section by section. My dear Lord Nisringadeva, O Supreme,
O Usvevišnji,
because of a bodily conception of life,
zbog tjelesnog shvaćanja života,
embodied souls neglected and not cared for by you,
potjelovanjem duše koje si zanemario,
cannot do anything for their betterment.
I o kojima se ne brineš, ne mogu učiniti ništa da bi poboljšali.
Whatever remedies they accept,
da bi poboljšali svoje stanje. Svaki lijek koji prihvate,
although perhaps temporarily beneficial,
mnoge može pružiti privremenu dobrobit,
are certainly impermanent.
Bez sumnje je privremen.
For example,
na primjer,
a father and mother cannot protect their child.
Otac i majka ne mogu zaštititi svoje dijete.
A physician and medicine cannot relieve a suffering patient.
Ljekar i ljekovi ne mogu ublažiti patnje pacijenta.
And a boat on the ocean cannot protect a drowning man.
A čamac u oceanu ne može zaštititi čovjeka koji se utapa.
And Prabhupada makes the point that these different remedies that people use in order to protect themselves from danger can only be successful if Krishna allows it.
Šta Prabhupada ukazuje na to da ti različite metode pomoću kojima ljudi pokušavaju sebe zaštititi mogu biti učinkovite samo ako im Krishna to dozvoli.
A person is sleeping in bed.
Osoba spava u krevetu.
Very peacefully.
Veoma spokojno.
They have a dream.
I sanja.
Somewhat of a bad dream.
Ponekad loše snove.
They toss in their bed.
I vrti se u krevetu.
They fall out of their bed.
I ispadne iz kreveta.
They hit their head on the floor.
I onda padne glavom na pod.
They die.
I umre.
Sleeping so nicely in their comfortable bed, the next minute they're dead.
Znači, spavao je spokojno u svom udobnom krevetu i u sljedeće minute je mrtav.
I was just in the Ukraine.
Ja sam čuo da je to bilo u Ukrajini. Ja sam sad bio u Ukrajini.
On the eastern side of the Ukraine, there is a war going on.
Na istočnoj strani Ukrajine se vodi rat.
And many devotees are also living in that area.
I bhakti isto žive u tom dijelu.
One devotee was captured.
Jedan bhakta je bio uhapšen.
And he was, they tried to kill him.
I pokušavali su ga ubiti.
They tried two ways to kill him.
Pokušali su na dva načina.
Didn't work.
Nije funkcioniralo.
Krishna saved him both times.
Krishna ga spasio oba puta.
He made friends with one of the doctors who was there.
I sprijateljio se s jednim doktorom koji je tamo.
And when the soldiers were gone, the doctor let the devotee go and he escaped.
Kad su vojnici otišli nekuda, doktor ga je pustio da pobjegne.
Man falls out of his bed, dies.
Padne iz kreveta.
The man is captured by the enemy, is trying to kill, somehow lives.
A s druge strane, nekoga uhvate vojnici koji ga pokušavaju ubiti, a on pobjegne, ništa mu ne bude.
Good luck.
Sretno vam bilo.
Is that what it is?
E, to je to.
That doesn't answer the question.
To je odgovor na pitanje.
It's Krishna.
To je Krishna.
Rake Krishna Moneke, Mone Krishna Rake Ke. If Krishna wants to kill you, forget it. If Krishna wants to save you, nobody can harm you.
Ako Krishna želi nekoga ubiti, nikoga ne može spasiti. Ako Krishna nekoga želi zaštititi, niko mu ne može nauditi.
So, what's our position?
Koja je naša pozicija?
How do we know he's protecting us and how do we know he's not protecting us?
Kako mi znamo da nas Krishna štiti ili ne štiti?
He says, in fact, one of the sections of the Bhagavatam is called Posanam. Posanam means protection by the Lord.
Krishna kaže u jednom dijelu Srimad Bhagavatama, Posanam znači za gospodinova zaštita.
And Krishna explains that anyone who surrenders to me, I give full protection.
I Krishna kaže, svako ko se meni preda, ja mu dajem potpuno zaštitu.
Does that mean he's not protecting those who don't surrender?
Da li to znači da on ne štiti one koji se ne predaju?
No, he is.
Ne,
because as a loving father, he loves all living beings, even if they don't take shelter of him.
kao otac pun ljubavi, on voli sva živa bića, iako neka od njih ne uzimaju njegovu utočište.
Just like a father has many children. And one child is disobedient to the father, but still the father's love is for the child, even though the child doesn't follow the father.
Kao na primjer, otac može imati puno djece, a jedno djete ne slijedi njegove upute i veoma je neposlušno, ali ipak otac ga još uvijek voli.
But because the child is acting independent, therefore it takes a risk.
Ali zbog toga što to dijete djeluje neovisno od oca, ono uzima određeni rizik.
So Krishna gives protection depending on how much we accept his shelter.
Znači, Krishna nam daje zaštitu u onolikoj proporciji koliko mi prihvaćamo njegovo utočište.
And whatever independence we have, if we use it in the wrong way, we're risking our...
I ako mi svoju neovisnost iskoristimo na pogrešan način, mi...
Now, isn't that wonderful? We can't protect ourselves.
Znači, zar to nije
zaštitujuće? No,
mi ne možemo zaštititi sami sebe.
I mean, there's so many ways you could die.
Postoji toliko mnogo raznih načina kako možemo umrijeti.
Even a mosquito can fly in the room and be carrying a deadly disease and...
Čak recimo može doći zaraženi komarac koji prenosi smrtonosnu svoju bolest i uboleti.
What can you do?
Što možemo učiniti?
We're subject to the laws of material nature.
To je jednostavno način kako djeluje.
And the laws of material nature are very cruel.
A materijalna priroda je veoma okrutna.
They're extremely horrible.
I ekstremno je užasno.
We can see how people suffer.
I možemo vidjeti kako ljudi ispaštaju.
Maybe we've also experienced some.
Možda i mi imamo iskustvo.
When we take shelter of Krishna, Krishna says, I give full protection.
Ali kada uzmemo Krishna zaštitu, Krishna kaže...
I protect even those who don't take full protection. But I can only give them as much protection as they take shelter.
Ali Krishna kaže, ja štitim i one koji mi se ne predaju, ali dajem toliko zaštite onoliko koliko se ne
predaju. Because they've accepted the shelter of material energy, they are under that control.
Ako neko uzme utočište materijalne energije, onda je pod kontrolom materijalne energije.
So, Krishna is the all-powerful, all-loving, protecting parent.
Krishna je svemoćan i sve zaštitnički roditelj.
Isn't that wonderful?
Zato je divno.
That you have somebody who is the supreme power, is protecting you at all times.
Da to nije divno, da imamo nekoga koji ima najveću uzvišenu moć i da nas štiti sve vrijeme.
You might be thinking, well, sometimes devotees, you know, they also die.
Možemo misliti to da bhakti su umru.
Does that mean Krishna forgot?
Da, znači li to da ih Krishna zaboravio?
No, because what is he protecting?
Ne, što to
Krishna štiti? He's protecting our path back to the spiritual world.
On štiti naš put natrag kući u drugom svijetu.
He may protect our body.
On može zaštititi naše tijelo, ali ne mora.
But he, you are on, under his spiritual energy, therefore, even if you lose your body, you get a higher spiritual destination.
Jer dok god smo pod zaštitom njegove duhovne energije, čak i ako izgubimo tijelo, mi smo još uvijek pod zaštitom na putu do duhovnog savršenstva.
So that means, in all cases, Krishna is the only protector.
U svim slučajevima, Krishna je jedini zaštitnik.
And he also teaches us how we can take shelter of him.
I on nas također poučava kako možemo uzeti njegovo utočište.
I mean, what was Ajamil's qualification?
Koje su bile Ajamilne kvalifikacije?
He had some Sukriti, he was a Brahmin boy, he grew up in a religious family, but he became a sinful wretch.
Dobro, on je u mladosti bio Brahmana, djetnjak, ali rodio se u vajšnjavskoj porodici, ali je postao razvratnik.
He committed all kinds of sinful activities.
I izvršio sve različite vrste grešnih aktivnosti.
He was cheating, robbing, stealing, kidnapping, and having children.
Varao je, krao, ubijao, imao djecu.
But somehow or other, this is in Bhagavatam, in the sixth canto, at the end of his life, he chanted Narayan.
To je opisano u šestom pjevanju Šrimad Bhagavatam, na neki način na kraju svog života izgovarao ime Narayan.
And because he chanted Narayan, all the reactions of his sinful activities were practically destroyed simply by that one calling of the Lord's pure holy name.
I samo zato jer je zazivao ime gospodina Narajana u trenutku smrti, sve njegove reakcije na grešne aktivnosti su jednostavno iščezle.
And he actually attained a very high state wherein he went to Hardwar and finished out his spiritual life there and then went back home back to Godhead.
On je dostigao veoma visoku poziciju. Otišao je u Hardwar prakticirati strogosti i nakon što je napustio tijelo otišao u duhovni svijet.
How powerful is the Lord's holy name?
Koliko je moćno gospodinovo sveto ime?
It's as powerful as the Lord.
To je sama moć gospodina.
Can we measure the power of the Lord?
Možemo li zamisliti gospodinovu moć? Ne.
Therefore you cannot measure the powerful power of the Krishna's holy name.
Zato ne možemo izmjeriti moć gospodinovo
sveto ime. So one who takes shelter by taking shelter of Krishna's holy name receives the complete shelter and the complete mercy of Krishna.
Onaj ko uzime utočište gospodinovog svetog imena dobiva potpunu zaštitu i milost gospodina.
Why do we chant the holy names?
Zašto pjevamo sveta imena?
It uplifts our consciousness.
Da bismo bili svjesni.
It's the way to glorify the Lord.
Ne, da bismo slavili gospodina.
It makes us feel happy.
I da budemo sretni.
But it also gives us complete shelter at the Lord's lotus feet.
Pjevamo sveta imena da bismo dobili zaštitu gospodina.
When you are chanting the holy names, you are on the transcendental platform. You are not part of the material world.
Kada pjevamo sveta imena, mi se nalazimo na duhovnoj razini i nismo dio materijalnog svijeta.
As soon as you stop, you go down a little.
Čim se zaustavimo, čim stanemo, spuštamo se na dolje.
If you stop too long, you go too far down.
Ako na duže vrijeme prestanemo pjevati sveta imena, spuštamo se
chant again, you go up.
I kad počnem pjevati sveta imena, izgovarati
se. So why not chant more?
Zašto ne pjevati više?
Too many things to do.
Toliko mnogo na stvari ostali za učiniti.
So we want to stay in contact with Krishna, we can do it through his holy name.
Dakle, ako želimo ostati u kontaktu s Krishnom, to možemo učiniti kroz njegove sveta imena.
Krishna is merciful.
Krishna je milostiv.
But what? Something, there's something more merciful than Krishna.
Sorry, I missed that one.
It's his holy name.
Ono što je još milostivije od samog Krishna, to je njegovo sveto ime.
What is more merciful than Krishna is his holy name.
Što je još milostivije od samog Krishna?
Or there's actually something else that's more merciful than Krishna.
Je, zapravo postoji još nešto što je milostivije.
One who distributes Krishna's holy name.
Onaj koji dijeli drugima Krishna.
Because one who distributes Krishna's holy name is actually giving Krishna to everyone.
Onaj koji drugima dijeli sveta imena, on daje Krishna svakome.
So who could be more merciful than that?
I ko može biti milostivije od toga?
Giving the highest to everyone who is willing to receive the mercy.
On je najviši od svih koji gospodina dobiva milost.
So Srimad Bhagavatam is the essence of all spiritual practices.
Srimad Bhagavatam je suština svih duhovnih praksi.
If we take shelter of Bhagavatam,
ako uzmemo utočište
Bhagavatam, hear Bhagavatam,
slušamo Bhagavatam,
read Bhagavatam,
čitamo Bhagavatam,
recite Bhagavatam,
recitiramo Bhagavatam,
and become what we say fixed in the knowledge of Bhagavatam.
I ako budemo postavljamo usredotočeni i u znanju našeg Bhagavatam.
Chanting Hare Krishna is not enough.
Pjevanje Hare Krishna nije dobro.
Ooh, what did Maharaj say?
Ooh, šta to sam Maharaj rekao?
Everything's in the holy name.
Sve u svetom imenu.
Yeah, but Krishna manifests himself in two forms in this age.
Da, ali Krishna se manifestira na dva različita načina u ovom dobu.
The holy name?
Kroz sveto ime.
And Bhagavatam.
I kroz Bhagavatam.
If we want to purify ourselves in order to chant the holy name, we need to hear and read Bhagavatam.
Ako se želimo pročistiti da učinkovito slušamo sveto ime, trebamo se pročistiti kroz čitanje i slušanje Srimad Bhagavatama svaki dan.
Nasa prayeshu abhadreshu nityam bhagavata sevaya bhagavati uttama sloke bhakti bhagavati naistiki. By regular attendance in classes in Srimad Bhagavatam and by service to Krishna's pure devotee, all that is inauspicious within the heart is practically destroyed, and loving service unto the transcendent Lord is established as an irrevocable fact.
Regularnim slušanjem Srimad Bhagavatama,
by regular attendance in classes on Srimad Bhagavatam,
regularnim prisustvovanjem lekcijama Srimad Bhagavatam,
and by service to the pure devotee,
i služenjem čistom bhaktom,
all that is inauspicious within the heart
sve što je nepovoljno našem srcu
is practically destroyed.
Je gotovo uništeno.
And loving service unto the transcendent Lord
i ljubavna služba prema transcendentnom
is established as an irrevocable fact.
Se uspostavlja u našem srcu kao neopozna činjenica.
That fact that is not reversible.
Znači, to je činjenica koja ne može
biti obrnuta. Everything is there in Bhagavatam.
I to piše u Srimad Bhagavatam.
So we make Bhagavatam a daily part of our life.
Tako mi trebamo Bhagavatam učiniti dijelom naše svakodnevnice.
We will be in contact with Krishna. To transcendental knowledge. Hear Bhagavatam.
Slušati Bhagavatam.
Read Bhagavatam.
Čitati Bhagavatam.
Is hearing Bhagavatam and reading Bhagavatam the same?
Da li je slušanje i čitanje Bhagavatama isto?
No.
Ne.
Hearing Bhagavatam is higher than reading Bhagavatam.
Slušanje Bhagavatama je uzvišenije nego čitanje Bhagavatama.
Because the transcendental sound vibration given by Krishna's representative goes right to the heart and purifies the heart and awakens transcendental knowledge. Where reading may take a lot longer and one may not be able to understand through reading.
Čitanje Šrimad Bhagavatama, slušanje Šrimad Bhagavatama sa usana gospodinovog čistog bhakte može uticati na našu svjesnost i dati nam razumijevanje Šrimad Bhagavatama, dok ako mi sami čitamo Šrimad Bhagavatam, nije nužno da ćemo ga i razumijeti.
So you might say, well, what do I do?
Mi možemo se pitati što sada čujem.
I have to go to the temple every day and hear Bhagavatam class?
Trebam ići u hram svaki dan i slušati Bhagavatam lekciju.
Not always possible.
Nije uvijek moguće.
Turn on the tape.
A onda uključite
listen to your spiritual master or to Srila Prabhupada speak transcendental.
Uključite snimljenu lekciju tako da čujete svog duhovnog učitelja ili Srila Prabhupada kako govori Bhagavatam.
But listen with rapt attention.
Ali treba slušati
nekako. When you listen with rapt attention, that attention that's not broken by other thoughts.
Znači, nepodvojena pažnja je ona pažnja koja ne može biti poremećena ničim drugim.
You can realize Krishna simply through the sound vibration.
Krishna možemo realizirati kroz zvučnu vibraciju.
The whole basis of Bhagavatam, how it was transmitted, is from pure devotee to enthusiastic hearers.
Čitava suština Šrimad Bhagavatama može biti prerešena od strane čistog bhakte do iskrenog slušatelja.
Parikshit Maharaj was cursed to die in 7 days.
Parikshit Maharaj je bio proklet da umre za 7 dana.
There was no question he wasn't going to die.
I nije bilo uopće govora o tom da on neće umreti.
He didn't run to a physician.
On je izgubio svoju poziciju.
He didn't try to take various medicines and cures. He was ready. He gave up everything.
He was
the king of the world. He had wealth. He had power. He has prestige. He had a wonderful family. But then he was cursed to die. He didn't go out and put a down payment on a new house.
Or
trying to get an upgrade in his computer. He didn't make any attempt to improve his material condition, nor even to try to prevent his death.
On nije učinio ništa da bi poboljšao svoju materijalnu poziciju niti da spriječi svoj smrt.
He took it as an opportunity to become perfect.
Već on iskoristio priliku da postane savršen.
He listened to Srimad Bhagavatam.
Slušao je Srimad Bhagavatam.
For 7 full days.
Na 7 dana.
From the greatest of all speakers, Sukadeva Goswami.
Od najvećeg od svih govornika Bhagavatama.
Incarnation. Radharani's parrot.
Shukadev Goswami is zapravo izvorno Radharanin papagaj.
And he, after 7 days, he fully realized Krishna in the pages of Bhagavatam.
I nakon 7 dana u potpunosti je spoznao Krishnu kroz riječ Srimad Bhagavatam.
What was the result of that realization?
I koji je bio rezultat te spoznaje?
He was completely fearless.
Bio je potpuno neustrašen.
How many people are fearless at the time of their death?
Koliko ljudi ima da su neustrašivi u trenutku smrti?
Even if you are 90% fearless, still that 10% you might think, well, what's going to happen to me when I go?
Čak i ako ste 90% neustrašivi, onih 10% može vas, možete se pitati, što će se dogoditi kad
ja to mogu? But he was completely fearless that he knew he's going to go back to Krishna.
Oni koji su potpuno neustrašivi, oni znaju da idu natrag kući Krišni.
He gained full knowledge and full fearlessness.
Oni dobivaju potpuno znanje, potpuno hrabrost.
And when death came, he welcomed death like anyone would welcome a friend.
I kad smrt dođe, oni joj izraze dobrodošlicu kao nekom svom prijatelju.
Simply by hearing Bhagavatam.
Jednostavno čitajući i slušajući Srimad Bhagavatam.
I remember I was in New Vrindavan.
Sjećam se, jednom sam bio u Novom Vrindavanu.
And there was one devotee there.
Tamo je bio jedan bhakta.
Her name was Kunti. Her name was Kunti.
Aha, njeno ime je bilo Kunti.
And she was there from the very beginning of New Vrindavan. She used to work hard and sacrifice her time, energy and health just to do her service.
Kunti je bila tamo od samog početka osnutka farme i žrtvovala se, radila je različite službe.
And she came down with a deadly disease.
I nju je oborila jebelna smrtna bolest.
And she simply decided, okay, now I'm going to hear Bhagavatam.
I ona je odlučila prije nego što umrla, sad ću ja slušati.
If you're going to come and see me when I'm sick, the only thing I want to talk about is Bhagavatam.
I ona je rekla, ako želite doći da me vidite u mojoj bolesti, jedino što želim čuti od vas je Srimad Bhagavatam.
Girl, don't come.
Inače mi nemojte dolaziti.
So devotees would come and take turns reading to her.
I onda kad bi bhakte dolazili do nje, onda bi su se mijenjali i čitali Srimad Bhagavatam.
And she would just listen to Bhagavatam.
I ona se slušala Srimad Bhagavatam.
And one time, one very advanced devotee was reading to her.
Jednom je jedan veoma napredni bhakta čitao.
And he was reading for some time.
Jedno je neko vrijeme tako
čitao. And he said, Kunti, how do you feel? What are you experiencing?
Kunti, kako se ti osjećaš? Što doživljavaš?
She said, I feel I am like Maharaj Pariksit on the banks of the Ganga River, Jamuna River, listening to Sukadeva Goswami.
Jedna rekla, ja se osjećam kao Pariksit Maharaj koji je na obali rijeke Gange i slušam Sukadeva Goswami.
She was so absorbed in Bhagavatam that she was feeling, this is like what Sukadeva was experiencing, or what Pariksit Maharaj was experiencing.
Ona je bila toliko absorbirana u Srimad Bhagavatam da je se osjećala kao, imala iskustvo kao da je bila u ulozi Pariksit Maharaja.
And that's how she left the body, simply hearing Bhagavatam.
I tako je ona napustila tijelo, slušajući Srimad Bhagavatam.
And she would chastise the devotees if they came and started to feel like they were crying at her own. She would say, why are you crying? I'm going to a better place.
I kad bi bhakti došli, jadikovali i plakali za njom, ona ih je prikorijevala, rekla je, zašto plačete, ja idem na bolje mjesto.
I'm happy.
Ja sam sretan.
Krishna is taking me back.
Krishna me uzima natrag sebi.
See, because she was absorbed in hearing Bhagavatam, she was feeling the presence of Krishna.
Samo zato što je slušala Srimad Bhagavatam, ona je osjetila Krishnino prisustvo.
So we have our modern day Pariksit Maharajas too.
Tako da i u moderno doba mi imamo Pariksit
Maharajas. And there's so many stories like that.
I postoji puno takvih priča.
How devotees have left their body either chanting the holy names of the Lord or remembering Krishna by hearing transcendental knowledge.
Ima tako priča da o bhaktama koji napuštaju tijelo pjevaći sveta imena gospodina ili slušajući priče, transcendentalne priče o gospodinu.
And Bhagavatam is so wonderful.
I Bhagavatam je tako divan.
You can read it, you can hear it, you can explain it, and you can never understand it.
Možete ga čitati, slušati, objasniti drugima i opet nikad ga ne razumijeti.
Isn't that amazing? If you can read something 100 times and still not understand it, isn't that something wonderful?
Začudujuće da recimo čitate nešto 100 puta i opet ne razumijete.
But at the same time, while you don't understand it, you're enjoying it. It's not like you're bewildered and you just can't. No, you're happy, but you understand this is wonderful, but I still can't understand.
Čak i ako ne možete razumjeti, vi ste sretni i dođete do zaključka, ovo je divno, ali jednostavno ne mogu stati.
Because if you can imagine a beautiful form of Krishna,
ako možete zamisliti prekrasan oblik Krishna,
picture in your mind your favorite form of Bhagavan Shri Krishna.
Zamislite u svom umu vaš omiljeni oblik gospodina Bhagavana Krishna.
Shamsundar.
Shamsundar.
Or Madan Mohan.
Ili Madan Mohan.
Govindaji.
Govinda.
Gopinath. Oh.
Gopinath.
So many beautiful forms of the Lord. Imagine that form in your mind.
Znači, zamislite u umu takav jedan oblik.
Think of his feet.
I mislite na njegova stopala.
On the bottom of his feet, they're like reddish color.
Znači, na dnu svojih stopala on
ima tenkastu. Why are they red? Why are they red on the bottom?
Zašto su stopala crvenkasta?
Because Radharani looks at his feet, and when she looks at his feet, she puts her shakti into his feet, and his feet turn red.
Zato što kad je Shrimati Radharani gledala u stopala Krishna, ona je uložila svoju moć u njih i stopala Krishna su pocrvenkasta.
So he's got two feet.
Sorry?
He's got two feet.
On ima dva stopala.
Yeah, he's got one. He's got a left one.
Yeah,
he's got two feet. Now, Bhagavatam is 12 cantos.
Bhagavatam is 12 cantos.
So the first canto and the second canto is Krishna's two feet. The third and fourth are his thighs.
Treće i četvrto pjevanje su njegove butine.
Fifth is the center of his body, the chest.
Peto mu je na prsima.
Sixth and seventh are his arms.
Šesto i sedmo pjevanje Bhagavatama su njegove ruke.
Eighth is his throat.
Osmo njegovo grlo.
Forgot where ninth is. Ninth is somewhere up there. The tenth is his face. And the 11th is his forehead. So the transcendental body of the Lord is not different than the 12 cantos of Srimad
Bhagavatam.
And this is not some figment of imagination that somebody came up just to sound good.
To nije samo nekakva izmišljotina da bi se neko osjećao dobro.
It's an actual literary reality. As you approach the deity through the different parts of his body, you're approaching Krishna through the different cantos of Srimad Bhagavatam.
Znači, kad prilazimo božanstvima, različitim dijelima tijela božanstvima, mi zapravo prilazimo različitim pjevanjima Srimad Bhagavatama.
But what is the most beautiful part of Krishna's transcendental body?
Koji je najdivniji oblik dio gospodinog tijela, transcendentalnog?
His face. But what's even more beautiful?
Smile.
The smile.
Njegov osmih, neko kaže.
His smile is even sweeter.
Njegov osmih je još slađi.
So the 10th canto is Krishna's smiling face. His loving affairs with his gopis and his friends in Sri Vrindavan Dham.
Tamo je opisano kako on uživa sa gopijama i svojim prijateljima.
This is the essence of Bhagavatam.
I tu je data suština Bhagavatam.
What is God?
Tko je Bog?
He's a coward boy.
On je dječak pastir.
Plays a flute.
Svira flautu.
He's got a lot of girlfriends.
Ima puno prijateljica.
And he has a lot of boyfriends.
I prijatelja.
And he's mischievous.
I?
Isn't that a wonderful God to worship? Mischievous. You know what mischievous is.
Mischievous.
This is God.
To je Bog.
Somebody says, well, what is your God like?
Neko može pitati kako izgleda tvoj Bog.
He steals butter.
On krade maslac.
He steals the clothes of girls.
On krade odjeću djevojaka.
And he plays with friends.
Igra se s prijateljima.
Plays all kinds of games.
Sve različite vrste igra.
One of his favorite games is hide and seek.
Koja je njegova omiljena igra?
How many of you played hide and seek when you were a kid?
Koliko od vas je igrao žmijeka kad...
How many of you still play it?
Više se još uvijek igra.
Krishna plays it all the time.
Krishna said that either, tako,
so, they were playing one time. And Radharani, she was the one to have a find everybody. So all the gopis hid. Krishna hid also. Now the gopis, because they have so much love for Radharani, that when she comes near them to find them, they can't hide.
Gopije imaju toliko mnogo ljubav prema Šrimati Radharani i kada je ona tražila da ih nađe, one se jednostavno nisu mogle sakriti.
As soon as she gets close to them, they start laughing.
I čim bi se ona njima približila, oni bi se počeli smijati.
Radharani catches them.
I onda bi ih Radharani otkrila.
So she caught all the gopis.
I tako ih ona razotkrila sve.
But she couldn't catch Krishna.
Ali nije mogla razotkrila.
Because every time she got near Krishna, he switched positions.
Dakle, Krishna je prigrio svoju poziciju.
He was going from one place to another.
I on bi mijenjao lokaciju.
She was thinking, how am I going to catch him?
I ona misla, kako ću ga uhvatiti.
And she tried.
I pokušavala.
But Krishna was faster and trickier.
Ali Krishna bio brži.
So she decided to use some methods.
I onda je ona htjela poslati poruku.
She started to sing.
Počela pjevati.
And she was singing the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra.
Počela pjevati Maha
Mantra. So beautifully, with such devotion.
Počela je pjevati se tako divno i sa devocijom.
Krishna heard her singing.
I kada je Krishna čuo njenu pjevanje.
And then froze. Couldn't move.
A ukoči se, nije se mogao maknuti.
And then she caught him.
I onda ga je uhvatila.
She said, I caught you. He said, you cheated.
Yeah, on je rekao, prevarila se.
That wasn't fair.
To nije bilo fair.
And then she said, no, you're just a bad loser, that's
all. Ti si jednostavno loš gubitnik.
So that's how you catch Krishna.
Eto, na taj način možemo uhvatiti Krishna.
Not just with the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra.
Znači, kroz Hare Krishna Maha Mantra.
But with love.
Ali ne samo kroz Maha Mantra, nego i s ljubav.
We all have love. What are we doing with our love?
Svi imamo mi ljubav, što mi radimo s
tobom? I love my Dell computer.
Ja volim moj Dell computer.
Or Mac.
Ili Mac.
He's even more lovable. I knew Satchimata would react to that. So we love our computer.
Okay,
we love our car.
Svoje auto, volimo.
Oh, we love our children. We love our husband.
Volimo svog muža.
Sometimes. And we love our wife.
Volimo svog muža.
There is no life without wife. It's simply full of strife.
Kakav je život žene?
So we have so much love.
Imamo toliko puno ljubavi.
Love, love,
ljubav, ljubav, ljubav.
But is that what is it we gain fulfillment from that kind of love?
Are we
finding happiness in that? But when you love Krishna, because Krishna is the source of everything, he's the source of the love we have for him. He's made our love in such a way that it only can be fulfilled with him. Isn't that wonderful? If he gives you love, and at the same time you can only find that love in him.
Znači, on nam daje tu ljubav, i tu ljubav, a to je ta ljubav koju možemo naći samo u njemu.
You might say, well, I do love other things and other people.
I mi možemo reći, ja volim druge stvari i druge ljude.
But it depends on your love for Krishna. When you love Krishna, it extends itself everywhere because Krishna is the source of everything.
Znači, ako volimo Krishna, onda istovremeno volimo i sve ostalo, i Krishna je izvor svega ostalog.
So therefore, Bhagavatam teaches us Krishna.
Znači, Srimad Bhagavatam nas poučava o Krishna.
And Krishna is so lovable.
Krishna je tako
the more we hear about Krishna, the more we get attracted to Krishna.
Što više slušamo o Krishni, tim više budemo privučeni njime.
And then the more we chant Krishna's name.
I onda tim više želimo pjevati njegovo sveta imena.
Because you won't chant somebody's name if you're not attracted to them, right?
Znači, pjevamo nečija sveta imena, nečija imena, ako ga želimo privući.
You know, just like when you get married. You know, you chant the name of your wife or husband all the time for a while. And then after a while that chanting becomes namabhas. Then it comes namaparaya. Hey! It's a different kind of chanting. So, you know, we go through different stages of love. But with Krishna, it only gets better. It's just the way the world is. Everything material is nice at the beginning. But maybe it gets a little better. Even after some time, it gets a little better. Then after a while, give me something new. Give me something different.
Nakon nekog vremena gubimo interes za to i mislimo dajte mi nešto novo, dajte mi nešto drugačije.
But not with Krishna.
Ali to nije slučaj sa Krishna.
The more you taste Krishna, the more the sweeter it is, and the more you want.
Čim više kušamo Krishnu, on tim više osjećamo njegovu slatkoću, tim više ga želimo. Sve stvari se postaju.
Isn't that amazing? Something that only gets better.
To je nešto što stalno postaje.
Is there anything in this world, I mean, what we might think, what is my favorite thing to eat?
Favorite what?
Favorite thing to eat.
Koja je moja najomiljenija stvar da jeo?
Pizza! Or, well, what is it? Strudel. Something, think of what you really like.
Zaista nešto što zaista volim.
And someone gives you a piece and you say, oh, so nice.
I neko vam da pisu, wow.
And then he said, yeah, give me another piece.
Okay.
So you have the second piece. And that's also nice.
I taj,
and third piece.
Treći komad.
It's not as nice as the second one.
Nije baš tako dobar komad.
Fourth piece, oh no.
Hoće još pice.
Can't do it anymore. That's finished. Right? There's a limit.
Ima ograničenje.
It's just the way life is.
I tako čitav.
Everything in your life, it's like you can only take a little bit and after you take too much.
Takav je život. Ako uzmemo nešto što volimo,
too much husband, too much wife.
Ako dobijemo malo više od toga, onda postane već prošli.
Too much pressure. Too much anything.
Previše bilo čega.
Give me something different.
Da, give me nešto drugačije.
But with Krishna, it only gets better.
Give me more. That's Krishna.
And when you find Krishna, you find everything else. Does that mean we can't love anybody else? No. Because when you actually love Krishna, you actually love everybody.
Zaista volimo Krishnu, onda volimo svakog.
How is it possible to love everybody?
Kako je moguće voliti svakog?
It's not. But because everything is within Krishna and Krishna is within everybody, because one sees Krishna within everyone, then one actually works in the best possible way to do the highest good to everyone at every moment.
That's Krishna. Kako je moguće voljeti svakoga? Krishna je u svakome i svi su u Krishna. I najbolji način da volimo svakoga je da volimo samoga Krishna. I to obuhvaća sve ostalo.
And how do we learn about Krishna?
I kako naučimo o Krishna?
Srimad Bhagavatam.
Srimad Bhagavatam.
Srila Prabhupada spent the best part of the day, the wee hours in the morning, simply giving us Bhagavatam.
Srila Prabhupada je koristio najbolje dijelove dana jako rano ujutro da bi prevodio Srimad Bhagavatam.
No matter where he was in the world,
gdje god da se nalazi u svijetu,
when it came to midnight, 12 o'clock midnight, he would begin giving his Bhaktivedanta purports for Bhagavatam.
I gdje god da se nalazio kad bi kucnula ponoć, on je počeo prevoditi Srimad Bhagavatam i pisao svoje komentare.
He wanted to give this to the world.
On je htio to ostaviti s čitavom svijetu.
Because he knew Bhagavatam was the solution to all problems and the means for understanding Krishna.
On je znao da je Srimad Bhagavatam rješenje za sve probleme i način kako možemo shvatiti Krishnu.
So we can hear Bhagavatam.
Mi možemo slušati
Bhagavatam. We can read Bhagavatam.
Čitati ga.
We can distribute Bhagavatam.
Bhagavatam.
We can speak about Bhagavatam.
Možemo govoriti o Bhagavatamu.
We can write about realizations after we read Bhagavatam.
Možemo pisati o spoznajama nakon čitanja Bhagavatama.
If we somehow or other find, make Bhagavatam a big part of our life, we found Krishna.
Ako na neki način učinimo Srimad Bhagavatam značajnim dijelom svog života, onda
smo našli Krishna. Srimad Bhagavatam and Krishna are non-different.
Jer Srimad Bhagavatam i Krishna se ne razlikuju.
Non-different. No difference. As Krishna is non-different than his holy name,
kao što se Krishna ne razlikuje od svog svetog
imena, tako
se ne razlikuje od Srimad Bhagavatam.
Srimad Bhagavatam amalam puranam.
Srimad Bhagavatam je amalam puranam.
The last verse in Srimad Bhagavatam glorifies the Harinam Sankirtan. It ends with the glorification of Sri Krishna Sankirtan.
Srimad Bhagavatam slavi Krishna Sankirtan pokret,
which is the essence of the teachings of Bhagavatam.
Koja je suština učenja Srimad Bhagavatama.
There's so much about Bhagavatam we can say.
Ima nešto još što bismo mogli reći o Bhagavatamu.
As Krishna is unlimited, so is Bhagavatam.
Baš kao što je Krishna neograničen, tako i Bhagavatam.
So, take time.
To će trebati neko vrijeme.
Make some time and every day connect with Bhagavatam.
Uložite svaki dan neko vrijeme da se povežete s Bhagavatamom.
And guaranteed you'll feel something wonderful has happened.
Ja garantiram da doživjet ćeš nešto predivno.
Because Bhagavatam is Krishna.
Yeah, Bhagavatam jest Krishna.
As the holy name is Krishna, so is Bhagavatam.
Kao što je sveto ime Krishna, tako je Bhagavatam.
Thank you. Srimad Bhagavatam ki
jai.
Srila Prabhupada ki
jai.
Nema svetlo što normalni Maharaj ki
jai.
Any questions?
No, neko pitanje.
Yes, Subhitri.
If we devotees love Krishna, why do we have so many problems in our relationship, divorces and so much intrigue? Does it prove that we actually do not love Krishna?
Why do we have so many problems with
relationships among each other?
Well, it's simple. Because if we try to give when we're with people, then there's no relationship. If you try to get something out of people, then you can have a problem. If you're always trying to give something to somebody, you're happy. Whether they take it or don't take it,
there's no problem. Mi možemo osjetiti sreću kad dajemo nešto drugim ljudima, ali ne možemo osjetiti sreću kad samo uzimamo nešto drugim.
So to associate with devotees means to associate and bring Krishna into the center of that association.
Družiti se s bhaktama konkretno znači staviti Krishnu u centar naše družbe.
By talking about Krishna.
Da govorimo o Krishni.
Talking about the activities of devotional service.
I da govorimo o aktivnostima predanog služenja.
Being friends with other devotees.
Da budemo prijatelji s drugim bhaktama.
In other words, you've got something, everyone has something, try to give it to somebody else.
Drugim riječima, svi imamo nešto i to trebamo podijeliti sa ostalima.
When we try to take, we may take something, but we may not. If two people are together and trying to take from each other, there will always be some disharmony, some discourse.
Znači, ako pokušavamo samo uzimati, a ne davati, bit će problem. Recimo, sretno se dvoje ljudi koji imaju takav mentalitet, samo da
uzimati.
No,
associate with the mood of service.
Trebamo se družiti u raspoloženju službe.
No, we can't associate with all devotees.
Opet, ne možemo se družiti.
All devotees are wonderful.
Svi bhakti su divni.
But we can associate with those devotees who have similar natures.
Ali mi se možemo družiti sa onim bhaktima koji imaju sličnu prirodu našoj.
And that's recommended.
I to je poručeno.
Associate with like-minded devotees.
Znači družite se s bhaktima koji imaju istu prirodu.
But we can respect all devotees.
Ali možemo respektirati sve bhakti.
Why? Because they're devotees. Why? We can respect everyone because they're a devotee.
Zašto da poštujemo sve ostale? Zato su bhakti.
So make friends with like-minded devotees and give respect to others.
Znači, družimo se s onima koji imaju istu prirodu kao i mi, slično, a ostale poštujemo.
We have different personalities.
Mi imamo različite osobnosti.
Sometimes personalities clash.
Ponekad se naše osobnosti sudaraju.
They say if you get married,
kaže se, ako biste se ženili,
you should get married to someone whose personality doesn't clash.
Trebate se oženiti onda sa nekim, s partnerom, čija osobnost se ne sudara s vašom osobnošću.
They say, marry someone who has similar natures, similar likings.
Znači, oženite se za nekoga koji ima sličnu prirodu i koji voli slične stvari.
Make friends with people who have similar natures, similar likings.
Sprijateljite se s ljudima koji imaju sličnu prirodu kao vi i koji vole iste stvari, slične stvari.
And respect everyone else, even though you're different.
A sve ostale poštujte iako su različiti od vas.
Because we're all trying to serve Krishna.
Jer mi svi pokušavamo služiti Krishna.
So we can appreciate that.
I to trebamo cijeniti.
But if we're looking for harmony, we should find it with those devotees who have similar natures like
that. Znači, ako tražimo harmoniju, to trebamo nalaziti u bhaktama koji imaju prirodu sličnu našoj.
And you know.
I vi ćete to znati, koji su.
You can be friendly with everybody, but only friends with some.
Možete biti prijateljski raspoloženi prema svakome, ali istinski prijatelj samo sa nekima.
That's the way life is.
Takav je život.
We're all different.
Svi su mi različiti.
Materially.
Materially.
Spiritually we're all the same.
Duhovno smo svi isti.
On the highest platform,
na najvišem nivou,
then we can relate with everybody.
Na najvišem našoj razini možemo se obhoditi sa svakim.
But we shouldn't try to be on the highest platform if we're not.
Ali ne trebamo pokušavati glumiti da budemo na najvišem nivou ako nismo.
So devotee should know what level I can practice on and how to interact with other devotees.
I trebamo znati na kojem se razini nalazimo i kako da imamo interakciju s drugim.
And Bhaktivinoda Thakur gives the formula. He said, somehow I go on in this world because I give respect to everyone.
Bhaktivinoda Thakur je dao formulu, on je rekao, formulu uspjeha, rekao je, ja još uvijek nekako opstojim u ovom svijetu jer ja respektiram
svakoga. We can respectfully disagree.
Mi se možemo ne slagati s njim.
We can honor the person because they are part of Krishna, part and parcel of Krishna, but we completely disagree with the way they do things and how they think.
Mi se možemo slagati s tim da je osoba dio djelić Krishna, ali se možemo ne slagati s načinom kako on djeluje misli.
What is astrology?
Što je astrology?
Astrology is to find out, you know, how to connect things that are similar and avoid things that are different.
Astrologija ima za cilj kako da poveže stvari koje su slične, a odvojiti stvari koje su jako različite.
The material energy is so complicated.
Materijalna energija je tako komplicirana.
There is so much diversity.
I postoji toliko različitosti.
To find unity, you can only find it on the spiritual level.
Ali jedinstvo možemo samo naći pod okriljem duhovnosti.
So, if we want to be happy in association with devotees, just try to serve devotees whenever the opportunity comes.
Ako želiš biti, ako želiš biti sretni u društvu bhakta, samo biti i trebamo služiti u svim prilikama.
Everyone has some talent.
Svako ima nekakav talent.
Some people can sing. Some people can sing.
A neki ljudi mogu pjevati.
Sing and that way please the devotees by your singing. Some people can play mridanga.
Bhakta pjevanjem ili sviranjem mridanga.
Offer that as a service to the Vaishnavas.
I to tako treba pojuriti kao što su
vaši. Some can cook very nicely.
Neko kuha veoma dobro.
Offer that as a service.
I eto prilika za
some people are expert at keeping things very clean.
Neki ljudi su jako dobri u održavanju čistoće.
That's the service.
I to je služba.
Some people are very friendly.
That's a service. Some people can speak spiritually on various topics. That's a service.
So
think, what is Krishna given
me? Krishna
has given everybody some abilities, some talents. How can I use it to serve the devotees? And as soon as you think like that, you'll get some ideas.
Ako porazmislite o tome, dobit ćete neke ideje.
And if you can't do nothing, just be happy.
Ako ne možeš ništa, onda jednostavno budi sretan.
That's me, I can't do it.
To sam ja, ja nemam ništa.
I just try to be happy. Peace. Sachi Mata was the first person I met when I came to Croatia.
Sachi Mata bila prva osoba koju sam sreo kad sam došao u Hrvatsku.
She was so enthusiastic.
Bila je tako entuzijastična.
Still is.
I još uvijek je.
Thank you.
I was kind of wondering when you were saying that listening Bhagavatam is actually what we should do, not just reading, because it may be that we cannot understand some things properly. But when we are reading Srila Prabhupada's purports, does it fit into category of listening, or if you can say a little bit more? Bilo je znači pitanje kad da slušamo slušanje Bhagavatama se smatra višim, boljim nego čitanjem, zato što možda nećemo razumjeti neke stvari ispravno. Ja sam pitala da li se čitanje Šrila Prabhupadovih komentara spada u kategoriju slušanja.
Prabhupada said to read his books, his course is very wonderful.
But he
said to hear the books from one who knows the books is the way for self-realization.
Ali slušanje njegovih knjiga od onih koji poznaju značenje njegovih knjiga put prema samospoznanju.
If someone is speaking about Prabhupada's books, then that is also as good as Prabhupada speaking of his own books. That speakers represent Prabhupada.
Kad neko govori o Šrila Prabhupada knjigama, to je jednako dobro kao kad Šrila Prabhupada govori o svojim
knjigama. Prabhupada gave the example that, you know, if you want to become a doctor, you simply read all the books, and then you know all the medical terms, and you know maybe all the formulas for medicine, but you're not qualified to be a doctor.
Yeah, ako želimo biti doktor, moramo čitati mnogo tih medicinskih knjiga, naučiti različite formule. Ako to ne učinimo, nismo kvalificirani.
You have to take certificate from one who knows. So hearing from a live person actually brings about realization.
Znači, mi možemo dobiti diplomu samo od onoga ko poznaje određenu nauku i koji nam može dati svoje spoznaje.
But that doesn't mean we shouldn't read the books.
We should read knjige, da, trebalo.
But every chance we get, we should come and hear.
Ali čim dobijemo priliku, trebamo doći i slušati.
Hearing is so wonderful.
Slušanje je tako divno.
It says that a dog sees with his nose.
Kaže se da pas vidi svojim nosom.
An ordinary human being sees with their eyes.
A prosječno ljudsko biće vidi svojim očima.
A devotee sees with his ears.
Bhakta vidi svojim ušima.
So hearing is the highest form of receiving knowledge.
A slušanje je najviši oblik primanja znanja.
Any other questions? Dog. No more questions. Yes.
In third canto is explaining.
Is in there.
Preparing
for the somebody's sleeping.
No, it's the tap
water. Water.
Yeah, tap water. Vishnu Priya, right?
said there was some signal we should take rest. Okay. Well, I was just giving an indication, maybe that's how boring my lecture was. Maybe in this case, seeing is a little better than hearing. Okay, question.
In third canto, is explained when Kapila Dev explaining to his mother. You know, he said before Jiva get in the human form of life, he start in the womb to pray to Krishna. Mm. That means Jiva is devotee in the womb. And after the get out, they forget everything. And can you explain this in some way? And how some devotee remember to be, remain to be devotee after the get born, like Prahlad Maharaj? U trećem poglavlju Šrimad Bhagavatam je Kapila Dev objašnjava svojoj majci kako beba u utrobi se moli Krišni, ne, što je jako teško, ne, moli se Krišni, molim te Krišna, izbavi me, ako me izbaviš ja ću biti bata, ne, ali vidimo kad se rodi da svi zaboravimo, znači, da li to znači da smo mi bili svi u utrobi bahte i kako to da neki ne zaborave, kao što je Prahlad Maharaj.
Well, that's qualified. The qualification is that this happens to pious living entities. It doesn't happen to all living entities. And it's explained that the seventh month, Krishna removes the covering over the living entity's mind and reveals that person as his devotee.
U sedmom mjesecu trudnoće Krišna osobno takvom pobožnom bhakti razotkriva zaborav uma i razotkriva se umu da je on zapravo bhakti.
Ne pobožnom bhakti, već džiri.
Džiri.
Krishna shows some mercy to this pious living entity. It makes him remember who he is.
On znači daje svoju milost takvom pobožnom živom biću i
At that time, that living entity in the womb, this happens in the seventh month. The living entity starts to pray, my dear Lord, I am your eternal servant. And somehow I'm in this material world and I'm going to again enter into the material world. But I am your devotee. So I pray that in this life I'll become your devotee. So the Jiva sincerely prays at the seventh month. But then when he comes out, he thinks, oh, this is not so bad. Everybody's smiling at me, you know. They're making faces at me. Not so bad out here. And he forgets. Sometimes. Unless he's a very highly elevated soul.
Osim ako nije zaista jako uzvišena duša.
So this is special mercy from the Lord.
To je posebna milost gospodina.
That the Lord reveals that living entity's position.
Kada gospodin razotkrije poziciju, izvornu poziciju tog živog bića.
But it doesn't happen to everybody.
Ali to se ne događa svakom.
Only those who are pious.
Samo onima koji su pobožni.
The Lord wants to help. The Lord goes out of his way to give the suffering soul as much mercy as he can so that the soul will somehow or other come back.
I gospodin se trudi na razne mogući načine da da milost toj zaboravnoj duši samo da bi mu se ona vratila natrag.
That's Krishna's mercy.
To je Krishna milost.
But then, if we get out, we forget.
I onda kad se rodi, se zaboravi.
We're surrounded by parents and relatives.
Okruženi roditeljima i rođacima.
And everyone is just taking care of us.
I svi vode brigu o djetetu.
And we forget.
I onda djete zaboravi.
Maya has two potencies. One is to forget Krishna, the other one is to throw you away from Krishna, so you are outside of Krishna. In other words, you are in her care.
Maya ima dvije različite vrste moći. Prvo vas primora da zaboravite Krishna, drugo baci vas daleko od Krishna i stavi vas pod svoju vlastitu kontrolu.
So therefore, the essence of religious principles is to always remember Krishna.
Suština religijskih načela je da se uvijek sjećamo Krishna.
Man mano bhava padma tom mam yuji man namaskuru. Krishna says, always remember me, become my devotee, offer your obeisances to me, offer prayers and worship to me, and then you will achieve perfection. You'll come back to me.
Krishna kaže, uvijek se sjećaj mene, služi me, obožavaj me, budi moj prijatelj, i onda ću ti ja dati svoju zaštitu i dati ćeš se meni.
This material world is simply a place of struggle. Everyone is struggling.
Materijalni svijet je svijet patnje.
You can't be happy here.
Ovdje ne možemo biti sretni.
If you're a devotee, then you can be happy.
Ali ako je neko čisti bat, bat se može biti sretni.
Although you're in the material world, you're not part of it.
Znači, iako smo u ovom svijetu, mi nismo dio njega.
But everyone in the material world, don't be fooled, they're all suffering.
Ali nemojte se zavaravati, svi ostali u materijalnom svijetu jako pate.
And the main thing of their suffering, they're always in fear. Fear of not gaining, fear of losing.
Strahuju od gubitka, da neće biti dobitnici.
Fear is a very powerful force that covers everyone's existence. Everyone is full of fear.
Strah je veoma moćan medijum koji prekriva svakoga u ovom svijetu.
Devotee is fearless.
Bhakti su neustrašeni.
Because he knows Krishna is there.
Zašto budemo pod strahom? Krishna je tu i štiti nas.
If I serve Krishna, Krishna takes care of me.
I ako ja služim Krishna, on vodi brigu o meni.
Therefore, devotee is not this without fear.
Zato su Bhakti neustrašeni.
Without fear, you're happy.
I kad ste neustrašeni, onda ste sretni.
Can you be happy and fearful at the same time?
Da li možete istovremeno biti preplašeni i sretni?
No. No, if you have fear, you're not happy. If you're happy, you're free from fear.
Znači, ako ste sretni, oslobođeni ste straha ili obratno.
So, any other questions? Okay, so what should we do now?
Šta ćemo sada činiti?
Kirtan. You want to sing? My voice is a little... I'm like Mr. Frog today. My voice is off.
Moj glas nije baš sam najbolji da bih
sad. I can try. Should I try? Okay, if you like Frog Kirtan. I will try to sing. Because we also have our Subhadra. Would you like to sing?
I would like you to sing.
You would like me to sing. I would like to make you happy, so I'll do it. Okay, I'll try to sing. But I have one condition. You have to sing loud. Sing from your heart.
Od svog srca.
Sing with all your enthusiasm. Sing like death is 1 minute away. Sing with... Because if you give your energy, that's also giving your body. Okay. So, thank you very much. Srila Prabhupada ki.
Jai.
Srila Bhagavatam ki.
Jai.